I think there's something wrong with me. I've lived my life like a game of chess, and the people I interact with are just pieces on the board, some more powerful than others. I've rarely understood another human being in any greater depth than that. My father taught us the game, but never played much himself. He had a distaste for competition. He said it brought out the worst in people. But to my brother and I, competition was everything. It was thrilling to win. It made me feel like I was invincible. Winning was the only thing that made sense in my life. It gave direction and purpose. It was the intoxicating nature of winning that led me to where I am today.
About the art of the hustle. It's really as simple as you think it is. It's all in the details, small things. You can remember all the small things and you're set. Take me, I act a little bit confident, like I think I'm the shit. Then I get my ass beat in a few games. Now I don't appear as a hustler, but just some dick that ain't very good. Hey, look at those two. Now here's another part of the hustle, choosing your mark. You can't go up and hustle any motherfucker. For one thing, they may be damn good. Now, they may be out to play straight games, or hell, they may be hustlers themselves. But these two, they ain't nothing but just some plain cheese dicks. Watch. They use up their time at the beginning of the game. He moves a piece up, then he's moving it back because he's under attack. Man, fucking pathetic. And the one on the left, he's the fucking worst. Now, fellas, this is exactly what we're looking for. Two rich boys ain't got nothing better to do than to give me their money. Now, watch how I do this shit.
Checkmate.
Bullshit.
Give it up. Total fucking bullshit.
Hey, man, you can't win them all.
Hey, man, you mind if I get in the game with you guys? I need some experience, and ain't too many people playing out.
No, man, I already got a game. Me and my brother have somewhat of a rivalry going on here.
Nah, you know what? Hey, go ahead and play these guys. I need a break, and it gets old being the champ, if you know what I mean.
Hey, and maybe we can learn something from each other, right?
Paul, come on, give me another chance.
Good.
Well, if you're gonna play with me, you're gonna have to put up some money.
Alright, I can do that.
How about, say, 100?
What about 5?
Big money player, huh? 500 it is.
Alright.
And who bade you stop this living art? Have you forgot just what you are?
That'll do it. Thanks for the game. We ought to do it again sometime.
Hey, wait a minute. You fucking hustled me, man.
Hustled? You came to me for a game, remember? It was a fair game, boy. Why don't you stick to something a little more your speed, like checkers? Or better yet, dominoes.
Hey, wait a fucking minute. I ain't gonna let any of you motherfuckers sit there and take my money. You know who the fuck I am?
If you couldn't afford to lose the money, then you shouldn't have gambled with it. If you think you're man enough to come take it from me now, here it is.
You might think that, because my brother and I spend so much of our time studying chess, we would perform very poorly in a fight. You'd be wrong.
Just how long it takes for you to understand where your feelings stop and
Jesus will have his revenge, you hateful little bastards!
That asshole actually had me going for 4 moves. 4 moves? Some little sack of shit and nobody in the park takes the fucking initiative.
Jesus, William, who gives a shit? I mean, that's what happens in fucking blitz chess. I mean, you can't win every single game. I'm playing the next mark.
Can't you see why I play these morons? It's not just for the money. It's a way of testing out new tactics and strategies. A way of honing my skills. I just want to get to the point where I can play these people and beat them without even trying. Just win without thinking.
Well, if you would listen to me and stop playing so aggressively, then maybe you could be the next Bobby fucking Fish or whatever it is you're trying to do. Or you know what? Maybe if you came out of the dungeon every now and then, you could win a tournament. I'm telling you, I'm going to take that World Chess Championship before you have a chance to play in a single tourney. You can mark my words on that.
You ever gonna give me back that queen?
Working on it.
It's a constant battle, being the best. You can never rest from the fear that they'll catch up with you. You always have to plan ahead, plan for the worst.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
To get your ass beat again?
If you say so.
Hey! Take this until you're ready to play me again. Until then, keep it as a reminder of who's best.
You know, you should really go see him. It might be your last chance.
I don't want to remember him like this.
That's just great, William. Just great. You know, you can't always do everything on your own terms. You can't go through life thinking only of yourself.
This is it. 25 grand for the winner. And if I can qualify for this, I'll be eligible for the World Chess Championship. You know what? You should enter.
We could double our chances, then we can split the winnings 50-50, and you could finally make your big debut on the tournament circuit.
So you don't want to win your bid for the World Chess Championship?
William, I'm not sure your zero-loss playing style is going to translate well into tournament format. I mean, we're talking dozens of games in one day. And these players aren't like the idiots that we hustle at the park. They've got skill.
My style is winning. It'll work wherever I apply it.
Oh, you boys spend way too much time at the park. You know what? And if it's not the park, it's this damn computer. And if it's not the computer, you're working out, or you're reading a book, or you're going over to the guy's house. I mean...
Just give me some sugar, baby.
I've got some series of openings I want you to try out.
I'll obliterate them for you.
Yeah, we'll see about that. What are you doing, man? Sit up.
Keep your fucking mouth closed and come with me if you want to live. You want to die, man? Turn the fuck around.
You boys don't know who we are, do you? And you definitely didn't know who the fuck those idiots were that you beat up and hustled either, did you? You know, I hate to admit this, but sometimes we do recruit less sophisticated individuals into our organization. I don't expect any explanation from either one of you two. What I expect is to sit back, relax, and maybe bask in this moment. With that blood flowing down your face, that heavy pounding from each heartbeat. Glorious, isn't it? Tell you what it is. It's fucking glorious to be alive. And what you two are gonna do is everything that I tell you to do. For next time, you won't be lying on the ground in pain, feeling so alive as you do right now. Next time, you won't find yourselves anywhere. Matter of fact, nobody will. You'll just be gone. Poof. Before you even know what happens. And it'll be nice and quiet like. That's why, let's say, 1 month? That's 30 days to you stupid fucks. You're gonna pay us $10,000. 1 month. And don't try anything stupid, okay? Because you know we'll find you. And definitely, definitely don't disappoint me. That's for sure. Come on, guys. Let's get out of here and leave these two lovebirds to think things over. William, Paul, stay out of trouble.
My glasses. Where the hell are we gonna get 10 grand?
The tournament. It's the only way.
There's no guarantee we can win that, William.
I say we just hustle some more players, you know, like tour. Just raking as much money as we can that way.
Fuck that. That's what got us into this situation in the first place. No, we train for and win the tournament. And then we still have 10 grand to pocket after it's all over. Just give me a week, a bag of chips, and a bottle of rum. I'll be ready.
Stick to the openings we practiced. If those don't pan out, use the tactics that we went over. Keep working at your strategy through the end game. We can do this.
See you in the finals.
Not far from reality. Would you ride against me? When you the line before, and just how long did it take for you to understand where your feelings stopped and right it began?
I resign. You've got me.
What? Look. Look, don't do that crap. Play your move, William.
Hey.
Hey. Haven't seen you around much. How's the new place?
Oh, it's good. I just got moved in. It's good.
Good.
William, you think we did the right thing? You know, with the money?
It's the only reasonable thing to do. Could have gone to the cops, who would have done nothing. Or we could have run.
And we could have just paid them.
If we would have paid them, they would have come back again and again until they sucked us dry. No, I know them. You have to take a stand against these kind of people.
who was so determined about winning the chess tournament and paying him off with the winnings. You know, I guess I should have known that your own greed and vanity would have got us both put in risk.
We split the money 50-50, remember? I didn't give a damn about the tournament or the trophy. It was all about the money. Once I had it, I realized I could pay off other debts. $25,000 didn't seem so big anymore.
I'm glad you could take time out of your busy schedule to come to the funeral. You should go see him.
I don't want to remember him like this.
You know what happens to everyone, William? This is one game you're just not going to win. Want that queen back now? Finally came out here to see him, William.
About time. What the fuck, Paul? You bring me all the way to this fucking cemetery to play a game of chess?
I just thought it would be fitting for your big defeat.
Get fucking real.
Fucking hilarious. You know, I don't know what's crazier, Paul. The fact that you brought me here to play, or that you think you can actually beat me.
You run that mouth of yours a lot, dear brother. Maybe you need some water.
No.
You're a loss.
That queen will be yours till the day you die.
Try to speak. You were more resistant to the cyanide than I expected. Don't freak out. It wasn't a lethal dose, but it was close enough. It was nice to beat you in our last game together. And this time you couldn't use any of your stupid little trick moves like you did in the tournament. You always had to use your little tricks to beat me. You could never win in a straight game. Always the little trickster.
Well, how do you like my trick, you stupid bastard? The pieces? Yeah, the pieces that you were using in hopes to beat me were laced with poison. How do you like that one, huh? Pretty good, huh? Yeah, Mr. Perfect didn't plan for this one, did he? Did he? Oh, yeah. Before I forget, it's time you have this back now. I'm the best. You are just a disgusting, pitiful human being.
I never thought it would come to this. I didn't want this. I tried to prevent it. Tried to make things right with Paul. In the tournament. In the beginning, he was winning. But in my most desperate moment, I prevailed. My Zwischenzug. The unexpected move. It was all it took to turn the tide. It probably wouldn't have worked on any other player in the world, but I knew my opponent well. Paul's problem was only that he was scared of losing to me. I had held the edge for too long. It ruined him in competition with me. Even so, he always could have been as good as me. I never told him that. But we all make choices in life. Maybe I've made a lot of bad ones. All I have left is my resolve to win, to keep playing this game the best way I know how. It was weakness and envy that ruined my brother. The sort of weakness that rots away at the soul like a disease. Fuck weakness. Fuck all those pathetic slaves who do nothing but delude themselves with the nonsense of this world so completely, there's nothing left of their own intuition or intelligence. They will drag you down with them. Fuck a job. Fuck the government.
I will put an end to crime in this state, especially when it comes to sex.
Fuck anything that stands in the way of your dreams. Your life.